Hello and welcome to After Before Friday's One Photo Focus for the month of March. This month, 25 photographers are post-processing an image submitted by Lori Dombage of Snows, Fissures, and Fractures, and we've all definitely enjoyed the challenge. I have to say, when I first saw Lori's image, I didn't quite know what I wanted to do with it, but in the end, I decided to try my hand at combining two photos using Photoshop, with the idea being that I would transform the image into a cafe overlooking something a bit more scenic than in the original photo. So to begin, I first cropped Lori's image to remove extraneous detail, and I've already set this up here so you can see what I've done. And I used a square crop and I angled it just a bit, and then I'm going to click done. So this is one image, and then I went through my library of images, and I found a photo that had a skyline of Seattle that I thought would work. This is my family. This is my daughter. We were heading out on a cruise to Alaska, actually, in this picture. So I'm going to take this picture and the one that I just cropped. Let me get back here. And I'm going to take that into, I'm going to open both in Lightroom. So I'm going to edit in Photoshop. It's about 2 a.m. here. I'm not doing very good in getting this done this week. Okay, and then I'm going to go back to Lightroom. Where is it? And I'm going to open up the picture of the Seattle skyline also. Edit in Photoshop. There we go. And it's going to bring it in. Edit with copy. Okay. So I have my two pictures. I'm going to move this one over here. And I'm going to start with Lori's. And what I'm going to do, now there may be, there's probably a better way to do this, but I'm pretty new in terms of using layers in Photoshop. So this is the way I know. I'm going to use the quick selection tool, and I'm going to hit my right bracket key on my computer, and I'm just going to hold the mouse button down. I'm going to drag. And as I drag over the picture, you see that it selects the portion that I'm dragging over. And I'm not going to do this really carefully for time reasons. Here, I want to get the chair in here, so I'm going to come over to my left bracket key and hit that, and I'm going to decrease the size of my cursor or my, whoopsie. If I get too much, I come back in and I hit the minus. Again, I am doing this really, really quickly. And once I get something here, I can come in and I can refine the edge and it will show me where the edge is that I've chosen. And if you can play with the sliders, again, I did this much more carefully to begin with. But if I move the radius, it, as you see, it moves the outline out a bit. You can just see all the different effects that you can get by adjusting the edge with the sliders. So again, this is a very rough selection. I'm going to hit OK, and it's going to output to a new layer with layer mask. So we've got that. Let me get this. So there is my selection, and I want to save it. So I'm going to hit Command C or copy it on my computer. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to come up here and come to my other picture, and I'm going to hit Command V to paste. I haven't seen that before, so let's see. Well, that's not something that happened the first time I did it, so I'm going to undo. Okay, Command Z. Well, sure. Actually, let me remove the layer. This is not anything. Let's show up. Okay. As I said, it's very early in the morning. Let me delete that layer. I'm going to come back here. I'm going to What I'm going to do is I'm going to move this layer into the picture. Okay, just by using this move tool. Okay, so now I'm in the picture that I want to be in, and I am going to simply adjust the picture in the way that I want to cover up my son's heads. This worked much better the first time around, but you know what? What can I say? It really did. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to accept that. Let's see if this is going to work. I'm going to come in here and I want to crop the picture so that I can get rid of the rest of what's here. I'm going to bring this down. I hope everybody's following this. And click on the check mark. Okay, so there you go. There's the picture in all its strange glory. And now I'm going to file, and I'm going to save. I'm going to save, not save as. And this is, should bring it back into Lightroom. Let's keep our fingers crossed. Save. Okay, let's see what happens if it's not there. Well, there it is. Okay, so it's a little skewed, funny, but that's because I wasn't taking my time. And then from here, I boosted some clarity. I came into my adjustment brushes, if I remember correctly, and I wanted to enhance some of this up here. Let me show you. I'll show you the... as I brush over, I'm going to make this bigger again very quickly. And I just applied all my basic edits using adjustment brushes on a lot of this. Okay, so you will see the before, the after using the enhancement. And I probably did boost some clarity, but in the end, this is the picture I ended up with, as opposed to this picture that I began with. And here is the picture that I actually worked on and ended up with the final edit. So I just wanted to show you how I combined the two pictures, and as for the other minor edits and the clarity and the brightness and adding some light. I'm not going to go into all that detail because I'm actually falling asleep. So, isn't this an instructive video, guys? I hope that you have gotten something out of this video. I apologize for the roughness of it, but I'd like to get this done and processed so that I can get it into the post that's due out not too long from here. So thanks for watching, everybody. Leave comments, suggestions, thumbs up, thumbs down in the comment section on my blog. Thanks, everybody.